My group is working at the intersection of microsystems and robotics. And this means two things, really. The first thing is that we work on sensors and actuators, really microsystems and microfabrication, to make large robots more capable. The second aspect of that is we build tiny robots. And tiny robots, I mean things the size of an ant or a flea, and ultimately there's a lot of trying to design new motors, new sensors, new mechanisms, often using both soft and rigid materials, and new ways of actually getting around in the world. One of the remarkable things about insects all the way up to larger animals is they are able to get around in the world very easily and adapt to the world around them. And one of the ways they are able to do this is because they're able to sense it much better than our larger scale robots can. One example of this is a moth is able to fly around, or a small insect is able to fly around, even if it's a little windy out. Whereas a small unmanned aerial vehicle, or UAV, if I try to fly that outside in the wind, a small gust is going to hit it and it's going to go unstable and crash to the ground very quickly. One of the ways that the moth is able to actually do this is it has hundreds of strain sensors across its wing. It's able to detect that gust and correct for it super quickly in comparison to what we can do on a robot. One of the things we currently use our robots for is scientific discovery. So we can create a physical model or a robot that's very much like an insect. We can change things on that robot more easily than a biologist can change them on an insect, and we can test hypotheses very quickly to understand, for example, how insects are able to jump like they do or run across surfaces like they do. Another more immediate application of small robots is inspection in industry. There are a lot of applications. Jet engines is one example, where a small robot could get in and inspect the engine, make sure everything's safe and okay, whereas larger robots can't necessarily do that. Another application is if I take the legs off of these small robots, now I have motors, sensors, and mechanisms all in these very small packages. And that can ultimately have a lot of impact on how we do things like minimally invasive surgery. I can do imaging and medical interventions much more easily than I can right now. Some of our work on things like sensors have more immediate impact. So we've developed both the sensors and software packages so that other groups can use them, or industry partners can use them. And we've shipped those sensors to groups working on things like prosthetics, on things like exoskeletons that interact with humans, as well as groups that work on haptics. In this case, the idea that a robot and a human could both carry the same thing together and feel the forces from each other. So one of the cool things about working at this intersection of microsystems and robotics is that there's no lack of challenges going forward. Like, as soon as you're able to design a motor, you still have to integrate it into a larger robot with the mechanisms, with the sensors. Once you've built a tiny robot, you still have all of these other challenges of, I can potentially create large numbers of these small robots. How do they ultimately interact together? So large colonies of ants and termites are able to do some pretty incredible things when they're working together. And so could we have our small robots ultimately do those same kind of things? So one of the things to take away from this is that building big robots is hard, and designing the sensors for them to interact with the world is hard. Building a tiny robot to do this is even more challenging, but I think even more fun and more exciting for future applications.